Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to generate or create a report in ServiceNow. The ServiceNow reports are visualizations of your data that you can share with users on dashboards and service portal, export to PDF and send via email, which is regularly required when you're working on ServiceNow platform in any enterprises. So if you really want to learn about ServiceNow report sections, how to create the report, how to view list of report, how to perform different operations like edit, update, view, and delete operation on report, please watch the video from start to end. So if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for further updates. So whenever I will upload a new video, you will be get notified. So as I said, ServiceNow reports are visualization of your data that you can share with users on dashboards and service portals, export to PDF and send via emails. So we'll learn here how to create, run, edit, view and share reports in detail. The ServiceNow system includes a range of predefined reports that provides data on applications and features like incident management and service catalog request. We can also create our own reports, add reports on homepage and dashboard to share information across our organizations. So here, there are different operations are required to perform or create a report. So run a report to view current data with an existing report configurations. Create report visualization means create a report to visualize and analyze current instance data or temporary data that you have imported. View the report list. View a list of reports and create reports from the report list. Copy a report means user who cannot create their own global reports can modify a global report and then see a personal version of the report. And finally, whenever it is not required, you can delete your report at any point of time. So let's see how we will create a report and perform these seven operations which we have discussed here. So let's directly jump to our ServiceNow instance where you have to just simply write report. And from here onwards, you will find it are different operations that are available here. So you can view and run report, simply click on this and you'll find it out different reports are available, which is by default created. So let's say if we want to see all incident by assignment, my group, simply click on this report and you will navigate to the edit portions. So this is how we are editing. You can simply select the assigned to or whichever field you are looking forward to create a report. Then what's the operation you're looking for? Assigned to, I want to create the report which is assigned to the different users, which all components are having to the different user. I will select different bars, even bar chart, time series, or different bars or reports are available. You can select as per your convenient requirement. So let's say I'm going ahead with this Pareto. Now, next, we have to do the configuration accordingly. So now I've created group by assigned to, and system by default, you can select max number of rows you are looking forward to create it. Then you can select title or axis, which axis or title you want to modify it and change it according to your need. Now click here all, you'll find it out. A very good generating report has been created. If you modify any of the fields at the future point of view, simply click this and click or run. This will again generate a beautiful report for you. So this is how we are creating the report. Now, if I want to share with directly to the user, I can simply export to PDF, add to dashboards or schedule. Even when we are scheduling, we have to make sure we need to define the name of the reports, how and what is the name I can use it. Then the report group. So here the report name is also required. Email addresses. If you have any specific email address or the username, you can simply add that administrator or any of the users which you want to, where you want to send these report. Then you can also add external email ID as well. And then run frequency, I'm keeping here monthly. So I want this report to be generated on monthly basis. And the time I can keep here like time, let's say 8 p.m. is the 8 a.m. in the morning. I want to keep this report to be generated. This is a 24 hours timeline. So when you will add 8, it means 8 in the morning. If you want to send it to the 8 p.m., then you have to define 20 here. So accordingly, this will send the mail. Now, if you have selected monthly, on which date you want to send this report. So if I will select 28, so it will send the email on 28th of every month. If I am sending on 1st of every month, so it will calculate all of the data and send it to the 1st of the every month. Then the subject line. So report from ServiceNow. ServiceNow. And you can include the body of your mail. Whatever you want to add the body of the mail and then click on submit. So this will schedule for you. When you will jump to the schedule report, you will find it out. These reports are already scheduled for future. So whenever the date will come, it will auto trigger an email to the administrator where these reports are generated or sent to their email ID. Now, if I want to create my own report, I will simply not from here. I will simply go to the view and run report. Or if I want to create a new report, I will simply click on create new. I will type the name of new report. New report. There's a name of the report. Source type I want from the table. And the table structure you have to define. On which table structure you want to instruct the data. Let's say I want to create the report based on the problems. So problem statement. We have this, click on next, select the format on visualization state. Let's say I am creating for the pie chart. So I will click on the next. So you can see this report is generated. Now, if I want to save into PNG and JPG file, that is also possible. Otherwise, I will directly share with different other components. Now, let's say I want to change different structure like title, legend, all everything is customizable. You can keep as per your requirement. So new report is the name of the report, title if you want to keep any specific title, and size of the chart also is customizable. Let's say I'm keeping here 24 and let me run this. This report will be zoomed. You can see here. Now if I want to add any legend, let me add to left and then run. So this report will move to the left section. So this is how the report is generated. And once it is done, we can directly share with this. So by this way, we can create a report, customize the report, and do specific operation on our ServiceNow report. Hope you have liked this video. If you really enjoyed the session, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. Thank you for watching.